Shri Gurubhyo Namaha. Creativity or Manodharmam is the hallmark of Carnatic music concerts. Manodharmam is extemporization of music. It is music created on the spot. A major portion of today's concert is occupied by Manodharma Sangeetham. So, it is important to understand the concept of Manodharma Sangeetham. Swathi Soft Solutions proudly presents a series of instructions on Manodharma Sangeeta, and these instructions have been presented by the legendary musician and musicologist Professor T.R.Subramanyam. We are very fortunate to have Professor T.R.Subramanyam right here with us to answer a few questions on Manodharma Sangeetham. Namaskar, Mama.
Hello, God bless you.
Could you please throw some light on what is Manodharma Sangeetham, the various aspects of Manodharma Sangeetham?
Yes, about Manodharma Sangeetham, in general, there is some information. There are a few sentences, one or two sentences of information I will let you know first. Number one is, Manodharma Sangeetham exists only in India, no one and no other system of music in the world. About Manodharma, Indians can very well be proud. So the Manodharma itself exists only in India and Indian music. So the Manodharma is a God-given gift, a gift to portray musical ideas. That is Manodharma in general. And you must have heard of temple festivals. 2 days back there was Varaha Perumal festival in Kanchipuram. That Perumal is given alankaram in various ways. On one day the god will come in procession on the back of a horse, Kudaravahanam, and then it will come under the back of Garudavahanam. Then on palm and some things, so many things. The God is portrayed and they were taken in procession in various forms.
Yes.
Did God ask anybody, no, I want to be portrayed like this? No. It is man's imagination. Man wants to say, be associated with God. So instead of seeing the God every day, as it is as a vikram, the mankind wanted that the attachment to the deities should be celebrated.
Mm-hmm.
So, this is Manodharma. Man wanted that God should be taken in procession in a particular form one day, some other form next day, like that. This Manodharma is towards God, like a deity, is bhakti, devotion to God. In music, the deity is raga. Also, the raga exists only in Indian music and nowhere else. The raga alapana, these things. Raga alapana.
Yes.
Raga alapana.
Yes.
This raga is God. It is. All ragas are portrayed as raga swarupa. Ragas have got swarupa. They are entities. They are not just a collection of sounds and all. Ragas are entities. In the Saraswati Mahal Library, there are these palm leaves where there is a shloka for every raga and the raga swarupa and also the portrait of the raga, the mantra and everything. So many details are there. The musicians do not know all those details, but they know the swarupa of the raga, raga swarupa. That raga is like God, it's God. We have to agree that raga is a God. Somebody wanted to portray raga and raga alapana. Another set of devotees wanted to portray raga in swarams. First of all, they wanted to compose songs in the raga and then sing the raga. And sing swaras in the raga, sing naraval in the raga. This is how this Manodharma is increased. It developed. Even as the same God is It's decorated in various ways according to the imagination of the bhakta. It is the imagination of the human kind. They thought that they would be serving the god, and that they, for their own satisfaction, they would take the god in procession in various forms and all that. Similarly, the goddess of Raga was intended to be portrayed in the form of a Kriti in the song, then in the form of Raga Alapana, and the singing Swarams in it. Like that, the Raga Swarupa is the main point. How beautifully to decorate it is the yearning of the man. Even as bhaktas, the musicians, music loving people, musician himself wanted that he should express the Raga in various ways. One is Kriti, then Raga in it, the Swaram in it, Naraval in it, like that. There are five branches of Manodharma, as I have, and I don't know whether I already said. Raga Alapana is from Manodharma. The Raga Kriti, a Kriti composing is got two stages. When it is being composed, it is Manodharma. It is Manodharma of a person, the composer. After that, when it is being sung by another musician, it is not Manodharma. The musician is singing only the imagination of the composer. His own contribution is not much there. So, the Raga Kriti, making Kriti is one stage. Then comes doing Alapana and the Raga. Then singing Kalpana Swaram. Kalpana, the Kalpana is Manodharma. Okay. Kalpana is imagination. Imagine the Raga, the portrayal of the Raga with the aid of Swaras. Not with the aid of phrases of Raga, but with the aid of Swaram, the Salpa notes. Then develop the Raga with the words found in the song.
Is there a logical approach to Manodharmam, or can it be sung at random?
The actions are governed by some dharma. This dharma, these rules, beneficiary rules. Dharma is adharmam is doing things at random, or doing things at random, or not at random, doing things as per some, say, mavericks or any human weaknesses, that is adharma. Dharma is maintaining the mental equipoise and do things in a manner that does not offend the other people, fellow human beings, and it is automatically governed by. For dharma, when you say dharma, there are certain codes which are automatically followed. So the very word dharma indicates that it's not that done at random. That dharma, it is controlling one's imagination and doing it according to certain norms, classical norms.
How does a musician develop and strengthen Manodharma Sangeetham?
Yes. The belief in India is, as expressed in Tyagaraja's song in Devagandhari, the meaning is O Sitara O Rama, Sangeeta Gyanam, knowledge in music, Dhata Vrayavalara, Dhata is Brahma. Brahma should have written on your head, otherwise you won't get music. So, basically, there should be a gift in the person learning music. Giftless people should not be put to music at all,
yes,
according to this.
Yes.
And it will be a waste of energy for both the student and the teacher. Only gifted students must be encouraged to learn music at that. And the natural gift in a student, it is the duty of the teacher to make it flower. There is no teaching as you teach mathematics or anything, accounting and all those things, not done. Music should be a product of inspiration. A good teacher must inspire the student first. At a particular higher level of inspiration is Manodharma Sangeetham. The inspiration comes by teaching the songs. The teaching of the music in the beginning is only teaching the sounds. And the sounds are taught with the help of words.
Like yes.
After being familiar with the sounds of music, the student must be able to produce his own music. That is Manodharma Sangeetham. That Manodharma Sangeetham comes, that the student should have not only knowledge but taste. Knowledge and taste are two different things. Knowledge and taste, the taste in a student makes him want to sing like that, sing like that, what that, that music is good like that. It comes out of exposure to musicians, great musicians of the past and present and all. And while listening to, and the teacher also be inspiring the student at the various stages. He must himself sing. He must himself be able to present music of a very high order that should create an impact upon the listener or the listening of the student. Because film music, if it is, say, aesthetically classical, the student must be able to inspire by it. And it starts with the habit of trying to trace the raga. In film music, they don't strictly conform to any particular raga or grammar. They go by the catchiness of the film music. Nowadays, there is a lot of interaction between film music and classical music. Nowadays, many people are giving lecture demonstration on this subject. Developing of the taste is the guru's main concern. The guru must be able to inspire a student to himself or herself want to sing this thing, I want to sing this, I want to sing that, not sing like that. For that, the guru himself must sing many things not in the reach of student already.
How important is it to be exposed and to listen to concerts to be able to sing Manodharma Sangeetham?
There should be a taste. The taste also is developed by God given grace. That's a gift. The taste, according to the taste, this is good music, this is better music, this is best music, like that.
Yes.
The student must be able to judge for himself and then try to emulate.
Right.
To whatever level he is able to do it. All musicians cannot sing all aspects.
Right.
Your voice is an essential part of good music.
Yes.
God, as I told you, God has written in the head that person must know music. Like that, God would have written that he should have a good voice also. That good voice is of various types. We have seen many great musicians in the past with the different voices.
Yeah.
I can tell you, M.D. Ramanathan was a great musician.
Yes.
He can never sing a song like GNP. Never. Their talents were two in different directions. There was one study by no less a person than an ICS retired man, S.Y. Krishnaswamy.
Mm-hmm.
He has written in a book, Tiger Vardachari and Veena Dharamwad, he compared.
Oh.
He says, Veena Dharamwad would sing a raga for 2 minutes and make you feel, what else is there in this raga? Everything is covered. She will give the essence of the raga in 2 minutes. Tiger Vardachari will sing a raga for 45 minutes and make the man ask for more.
Hmm.
There is still so much in the raga. He will be giving a feeling. So who would you consider a better artist? Veena Dharam or Tiger Vardachari? He has himself given a conclusion. No, I would conclude that the real greatness is in music, not in any of these arts. Indian music is so great, it will accommodate anything. Indian music is so great by which it can accommodate a Veena Dharam who can sing, bring the essence of the raga in 2 minutes and make people forget themselves. the same Indian music has got provision for a tiger or a chale who can sing a raga for part of a bridge. And make the man, make the listener feel that there is still so much aha, whatever can not be, like that. That is the greatness of Indian music, it is not the greatness of a particular person